In this lesson, you will learn how to make your programs interactive by using message boxes and input boxes. Message boxes allow you to deliver messages directly to the user. They are created using the MSGBOX function. The string that's placed after a message box will be displayed on the screen to the user, and the program will halt until the user acknowledges the message box. On sheet 2 of our workbook, the number 2 has been input into cell B2, and the number 3 has been input into cell B3. On the right, we have a macro named inOut. This macro will obtain data from the worksheet and store it in variables. The variables will be used to perform some calculations, and the results will be shown to the user using message boxes. Let's examine in detail what this macro will do. First, sheet 2 of the workbook will be selected using sheets, sheet 2 within quotes, dot select. Next, cell B2 will be selected with range B2 within quotes, dot select. Cell B2 on sheet 2 is now the active cell. The value in B2, which is 2, is assigned to the variable num1 using the statement num1 equals active cell dot value. Next, cell B3 becomes the active cell using range B3 dot select. The value in B3, the current active cell, is 3, and that's assigned to num2. In the next line, the variable ands is assigned the value of num1 plus num2, which is 5. Now we output some information to the user using message boxes. The first message box will display some text. When message box VBA is fun is executed, a message box will appear that states VBA is fun. The next message box will display the character string num1 equals, followed by the value of num1, which is 2. The ampersand combines the text on the left with the value of num1 on the right into one continuous character string. And it's this character string that's displayed on the message box. The last message box combines together 5 different items using 4 ampersands into one long string. The message to the user will be the value of num1, which is 2, then the plus sign, then the value of num2, which is 3, then the equal sign, and finally the value of the variable ands, which is 5. And finally, the macro is terminated with the end sub statement. Let's run this macro by clicking the run button. Select inOut and run. The first message box states VBA is fun. Notice how the program halts until I click OK or the X button at the top right of the message box. After I click OK, the second message box appears, and after I click OK once more, the third and final message box appears. Input boxes allow you to obtain data from the user through a pop-up window. They are created using the input box function. When using input boxes, the user will be prompted to enter data and the program will halt until the user enters that data. If you want the user to input a character string, which you'll then store in a variable, you write the name of the variable equals input box, and inside the parentheses, you'll write a message prompting the user to input data. Whatever the user inputs will be stored as a character string. If you want the user to input a number instead of a character string, you'll need to put the input box function inside of the val function. The val function will take the data that's input from the user and convert it from a string into a number. This example shows you how to use input boxes. The first line in the macro inout says fav color equals input box, what is your favorite color? This will create an input box that will prompt the user to answer the question, what is your favorite color? Whatever the user enters will be stored in the variable fav color. The next line will display to the user the phrase, your favorite color is, followed by whatever is stored in fav color. Next, we want to obtain a couple of numbers from the user and store them in the variables num1 and num2. By default, the input box function will store whatever the user inputs as a character string. But we want numbers to be stored in num1 and num2, so we need to use an additional function called val. Val will take whatever number the user inputs and convert it from a string to a number. Whenever you want the user to input numerical data, you should use the val function around input box. After the user has input values for num1 and num2, the sum of num1 and num2 will be calculated and stored in the variable ands. Next, a message box will appear that will display the message num1 equals followed by the value stored in num1. And lastly, a message box will appear displaying the value of num1 followed by plus, then the value of num2, then the equal sign, and then the value of ands. Let's run this program and examine how input boxes work. What's your favorite color? I will type red and hit enter. Your favorite color is red. Notice how the program halts whenever an input box or a message box appears. The program will always wait until the user acknowledges the message box or the input box. Enter number 1. I'll type 2. Enter number 2. I'll type 3. Num1 equals 2. 2 plus 3 equals 5.